In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good afternoon. It's nice seeing you. Dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge all our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with the salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, graciously keep from us all adversity, so that unhindered in mind and body alike, we may pursue in freedom of heart the things that are yours. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. Resplendent and unfading is wisdom. Wisdom is readily perceived by those who love her and found by those who seek her. Wisdom hastens to make herself known in anticipation of their desire. Whoever watches for her at dawn shall not be disappointed, for he shall find her sitting at his gate. For taking thought of wisdom is the perfection of prudence. Whoever for her sake keeps vigil shall quickly be free of care. Because she makes her own rounds, seeking those worthy of her, and wisdom graciously appears to them in the ways and meets them with all solicitude. The word of the Lord.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, my God.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, my God.
O God, you are my God, whom I seek. For you my flesh pines and my soul. Like the earth parched, lifeless and without water, my soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. Thus have I gazed toward you in the sanctuary to see your power and your glory. For your kindness is a greater good than life. My lips shall glorify you.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God.
Thus will I bless you while I live. Lifting up my hands, I will call upon your name. As with the riches of a banquet shall my soul be satisfied, and with exultant lips my mouth shall praise you. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. I will remember you upon my couch, and through the night watches I will meditate on you. You are my help, and in the shadows of your wings I shout for joy. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not grieve like the rest, who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring with him those who have fallen asleep. Indeed, we tell you this, on the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will surely not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with a word of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, will come down from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. 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 The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven will be like 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish and 5 were wise. The foolish ones, when taking their lamps, brought no oil with them, but the wise brought flask of oil with their lamps. Since the bridegroom was long delayed, they all became drowsy and fell asleep. At midnight, there was a cry. Behold, the bridegroom come out to meet him. Then all those virgins got up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish ones said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out." But the wise ones replied, "No, for there may not be enough for us and you. Go instead to the merchants and buy some for yourselves." While they went off to buy it, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went into the wedding feast with him. Then the door was locked. Afterwards, the other virgins came and said, "Lord, Lord, open the door for us." But he said in reply, "Amen, I say to you, I do not know you. Therefore, stay awake, for you know neither the day nor the hour." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to the Lord Jesus Christ. Stay awake and be ready, for you do not know on what day your Lord will come. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, as I was reading this gospel last night, I was reminded of my first wedding. Not my first wedding, the wedding I did after my ordination. It was really, it is funny, I can say, because 2003 I was ordained. January, there was a wedding. Usually people like to call the new priest for wedding. So they invited me, so I was so happy because that is going to be my first wedding to celebrate. So the wedding was at 11 a.m. You know, with the curiosity, I was ready by 10 o'clock. In India, usually, if it is 11 o'clock, I know that it would be 11:30 or 11:45, the mass. But I was ready by 10 o'clock, and I went to the church, and there was nobody. Around 10:45, the boy came. So usually in the Indian culture, the weddings, the boy comes first. Then afterwards, they go and bring the girl. So then we start the mass. The boy came around 10:45. I was so happy that we are going to start mass at 11 o'clock. And it was 11. the girl did not come. Then I thought, usually, not that I'm telling girls or a woman, usually the wedding time they put a lot of makeup and all these things. In India, they apply powder and all these things. So I thought maybe she might have gone to beauty parlor. She may come a little late. It was 11:15, 11:20, 11:30. I was a little scared because I told my mom not to prepare lunch. So it was 11:45, we get the news, the girl is missing. So she was not happy for the wedding, so she went with somebody whom she liked. So that is what I was thinking, because I waited for an hour, so the wedding did not take place. That was my experience for my first wedding. Some countries have the custom of the bride being a few minutes late for the wedding. It's still happening in some of the countries. But there was a different custom for weddings at the time of Jesus. It was the groom who had the privilege of delaying the bride at the time of Jesus. The wedding could take place any time within 2 weeks. So the poor bride had to be in a state of constant alert during those 2 weeks. However, the groom did make it easier for her by sending messengers to her house to warn that he would be coming later that day to pick her up for the wedding. Therefore, the bride and groom could not send out invitation cards because only the groom knew when the wedding would be, and he gave very little notice. He could choose any day and any hour within those 2 weeks. When the groom went to the bride's house to pick her up for the wedding, he would have to negotiate with her relatives the gifts he would give for the privilege of being able to marry her. Sometimes these negotiations could drag on for a time before he took the bride back to his house for the wedding. So it seems that in the parable Jesus told in the gospel today, there was a lot of negotiating about what gifts the groom should give. The groom's the negotiating went on so long that the bridesmaids back at the groom's house grew so tired on waiting that they fell asleep. When the bride and groom arrived in the groom's house, the parents pronounced a blessing over the happy couple, and the singing and dancing lasted for a week. No wonder they ran out of wine during the wedding at Cana. The bridesmaids in the parable were given an opportunity to be ready for the wedding in the groom's house later that evening. The groom had already sent word to the bride that the wedding would be later that day. They knew the wedding would take place. The only delay would be the negotiations with the bride's relatives. But five of them did not bring enough oil. They had an opportunity during the day to get a supply of oil, but they did not bother. Then, when the couple arrived for the wedding, it was too late, and those who had oil had only enough for themselves and were unable to share it. It reminds us that we have to make choices going through life, and we live afterwards with the consequences of those choices. There is no getting away from making choices. We have to make any decisions. The option we have is to choose well or choose badly. Whatever we choose, we will live with the consequences. Some of the bridesmaids in the parable squandered the opportunity they had during the day to get some oil. Like them, we have choices and decisions. We want to choose well because we pass this way only once. So, dear brothers and sisters, today's parable reminds each one of us to choose well, because at the end of life, we will meet our Savior, and we do not know when He will call us. So that is the only thing on this earth we don't know, when our life will get here and when He will call us. That is why Jesus said in the gospel, stay awake, because you do not know either the day or hour. Each decision or choice we make going through this life is a decision or choice for Jesus or against Jesus. There will be consequences to all our decisions for Jesus or against Jesus. When Jesus calls us from this life, whenever that will be, we will face the consequences of all our decisions for or against Jesus. So, dear brothers and sisters, stay awake, because you do not know either the day or hour. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible, I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He'll come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess on baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, life of the world to come. Amen. Trusting in God's mercy, let us put forward all our prayers and intentions.
That all who minister in the church be leaders who serve and servants who lead. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the families and friends of those who were killed or wounded in the shooting in Sutherland Springs, and for all those who have experienced violence in their lives, may they be comforted by the love of God and the compassion for all members of our church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That veterans who give service to our country receive the honor and appreciation they are due. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For members of the health professions, first responders, and civic leaders, may the Holy Spirit inspire them to work together to help all those who are affected by the scourge of addiction. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of consolation, we remember those who died, for those who passed away quietly. We ask for a joyful passage into your spacious heart. For those who suffered great pain, we ask for respite and comfort of your compassionate embrace. For those who died too soon, in sudden and unexpected ways, we ask for peace and surrender into your loving care. Grant all of those who have died, especially Gerald and Mayu Hart and Flora, Paul, Richard, Janet, Paul Jr., for whom this Mass is being offered, the grace of your eternal light and life. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. May the mystery of water and wine may come to divinity of Christ to humble himself for the whole humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual. Blessed be God forever. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Worship you, my iniquities, cleanse me from sins.
Time.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Look with favor, we pray, O Lord, upon the sacrificial gifts offered here, that celebrating in mystery the passion of your Son, we may honor it with loving devotion through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Who comes in the name of the Lord? Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, and he entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph and her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Thank you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ bring us to everlasting life. Amen. bless you, and on behalf of you, work for our country. You sacrifice yourself for our country. So, God bless you. May God bless you abundantly. Also, if you look back in the church, you will see the cards, the Christmas cards. The past 3 years, I think after our dance coming, we are getting a card from India, where I work, the school where I work nearby. And these cards are made by the children who are below 10 years. So they send us every year, and we make some donation for those children for Christmas, as well as for their studies. So if we can make a time and look at that one, there's cards, and you feel free to make any donations that will be collected. Then for them, would send those children for their Christmas expense, where they can have a good meal, and they can have good rest, and then for their studies. So you can just look into those things. May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Today's Mass has been brought to you through the generosity of Oakland Furniture, located at 12 Main Street, Oakland, Maine.
Like LB always says,
Oakland Furniture, nobody does it better.
Laurie Brothers Funeral Homes, located at 107 Main Street, Fairfield, Maine.
Get a great deal on a dependable vehicle that meets your needs and fits your budget. Choose an affordable pre-owned vehicle from Central Maine Motors Auto Group. You'll always find a great selection in stock, quality inspected and warrantied. And you'll save thousands when you purchase a factory-backed, certified used vehicle. For the right vehicle at the right price and the best in service with a full tank of gas, come get your keys at the place with no dock fees, Central Maine Motors Auto Group in Waterville, where cars and trucks always cost you less.
Celebrating, therefore, the memorial of the death and resurrection of your Son, who left us this pledge of his love, we offer you what you have given us, the perfect sacrifice of reconciliation. Also, together with your Son, and in this saving bank,
Mount St. Joseph, located at 7 Highwood Street, Waterville, Maine.